We will explain multiple steady states and how they arise for a simple system, a continuous stirred tank reactor operating at steady state. And some of the notation, Ca is the exit concentration, the volumetric flow rate, V0, and I'll V0 leaving, so we can just call this V then. Ca0 is inlet concentration of reactant, and Ca is the outlet concentration. Reactor volume is V. And we'll look at a first order reaction, a simple case. And liquid phase, exothermic. Exothermic is very important. If we're going to have multiple steady states for a simple type kinetics like this, then it has to be exothermic. And we'll also look at the case of adiabatic. You can certainly have multiple states when there's heat transfer. But in terms of simplifying the equation so we can see the behavior, that's the situation we'll look at. And so we also will want to compare this to a plug flow reactor. And so in just a very freehand drawing, let's look at how we would imagine a plug flow reactor reactant concentration changes as we move down the reactor. So tau is residence time. We increase the residence time. We move further down the reactor. And so what's going to happen for an adiabatic reactor, the rate's going to be relatively low, which means the concentration doesn't change very much. But as the reaction takes place, the heat of reaction heats up the reactants, which increases the rate constant exponentially. So the rate starts speeding up, which means the concentration drops faster. And then we have a compensating effect that we're running out of reactant. So even though the temperature is increasing, the concentration of reactant now is not decreasing as fast. And as we'll see with the equation, there's a linear relation between how much of A reacts and what the temperature is, or if you like, the conversion. And so the temperature, forget about what the starting value, but this would be the inlet temperature, just like this here, is Ca0 coming in. And this is zero. This is T0 coming in. So the temperature initially is not changing very fast. But as reaction proceeds and the temperature gets hotter, then the rate becomes faster, so the temperature rate increases. And exactly the shape, though I won't be able to draw it that well, where it goes up and then levels out. If I flip this upside down, it should look like this curve. Okay, so that's plug flow reactor, and we want to compare the plug flow to the CSTR. For plug flow, there's only one solution. Given residence time, there's one concentration. The CSTR is different. If we were to make the same plot for CSTR, it's going to, and so again, we're coming in at the same concentration. It's going to look like this, and this means the temperature, again, is going to mimic this, flipping it upside down. So the temperature is going to show the same type behavior. So here's CSTR, exothermic reaction, and adiabatic. Okay, and when I say these are exact, but just inverted, that's assuming constant heat capacities and constant heats of reaction, as we'll see shortly. But the important thing to notice is if I look at some residence time, there are actually three concentrations for one residence time. We don't see that for the plug flow reactor, but we see that for the CSTR. And so what this means is there's three solutions to reactor equation, three concentrations and correspondingly three temperatures, if I draw that better. Three concentrations, three temperature for the same residence time. So the important thing that we see is multiple solutions. That's for the CSTR. There's only one solution for the plug flow reactor. And the difference between these two is the feedback. Because we're operating at the final temperature can be high for an exothermic reaction that makes the rate fast. And that kind of feedback allows us, depending on where we start, but which condition we end up with at steady state, because we're looking at steady state solutions, right? These are all steady state. But the actual operating conditions, by operating conditions, I mean the concentration of the exit, the temperature at the exit, The operating conditions depend on how we start the reactor. We mean that we could start with a low temperature in the reactor. We could start with pure reactant, or we could start with 90% product. Or we could start with a high temperature in the reactor. Depending on where we start is going to determine where we'll end up. Okay, now these equations, like this feedback, the multiple solutions resolve because of the nonlinear equations, namely the mass and energy balances. So nonlinear equation and feedback due to mixing. So as we saw, we could have three solutions for this simple case. Not all solutions, however, are the same. In other words, a solution, so there are actually three types of solutions. Doesn't mean those three solutions are one of each type. Means we have the possibility of each of those solutions being one of these types. And the one that you might expect, the stable points, namely, it'll run at steady state at that condition. But it's also, solution can be an unstable point, meaning unless we use some sort of controller, it's not going to stay at that condition. It's a solution of the mass and energy balances, but any perturbation kicks it away from the solution. But we can certainly operate at this point, but it takes some sort of controller. And then the third type of possible solution is something called a limit cycle, which means we have oscillations around the point and they're sustained, so they'll continue for a long time. So this is just the introduction to the idea that we can have multiple states for CSTR. If we look at this system, we'll see for the simple system, this would be a stable point, this will be a stable point, and this would be an unstable point. It's not obvious how we know that from just this plot, but we'll see when we can look at more details to explain this. We can solve the unsteady state equations to determine whether something is a stable point or an unstable point.